Hey everybody, it's BoulderGuss5000, back with more Final Fantasy IV. In the last episode, we came to the Living Waterway, and in this episode, we're gonna go through the Living Waterway, that's Cave Story. In between episodes, I went back to town and I got Tella's name changed to Tella with an H, which I'm pretty sure is how it is in the DS translation, which is generally accepted to be the perfect official one, I'm pretty sure. So there you go. There's something else off screen too. Oh yeah, I actually equipped Tella with some useful armor. I gave him a hat. I bought him a hat, and I finally equipped that iron bangle I picked up in the last episode, but never even realized I had. Hopefully this recording turns out all right. Ice rod, hello. Because I've got kind of a monster headache right now, but I didn't have any Final Fantasy IV recorded, so I was like, well, I kind of gotta. Record an episode, man. If I'm gonna upload two videos a day, I kinda gotta record an episode. Which basically bites, but, well, what we gonna do? Hey, you, what you gonna do? What's in here? Awfully odd that they would have, wooden doors in this, I guess it's not that weird, considering that this area is actually, used by people to travel to Damsian. Oh, the cool thing you can do with this, a little bit of lag there. Cool thing you can do with this newfangled ice rod we just picked up is if you go into Rydia's items and use it as an item, it will cast a blizzard spell, which is quite nice indeed. It's a good way for her to attack when she doesn't have any magic left, because it doesn't use any magic to do that. Down here, I think this is where you find some equipment for Cecil. Oh, well, 580 gil, that's not equipment. Dode. More Gigantodes, gee whiz. Anyway. Bomb fragment. Okay, that's not what either of those were originally. Oh, hey, this is a new encounter. I saw this on my way backtracking, but I didn't really get a chance to show it, obviously. These are zombies. Pretty much best way to deal with these guys is to use fire. Or you can use curing magic on them. That works too. And it's a bit less expensive, but Cecil's Dark Sword, because it's Dark Elemental, doesn't do jack shit to these guys. So you're gonna have trouble fighting them if you plan on using just his sword to do the trick. It's not going to, is what I'm saying. It's not gonna do the trick. And that's the problem. That's the problem. You could have him use a potion on them, I guess. But I'm just gonna have him. You can't do that in this game. In Final Fantasy, what the hell? Okay, alright. Crying out loud. Fine, let's use the ice rod again. I was gonna use Cure 1, but Tella only has Cure 2. What? Oh, for crap. Dude, you're not dead yet? Gee whiz. There you go, that'll finish him off. Yeah, so Cecil's Dark Swords don't do jack shit to undead monsters. I'm going to switch to Toiletella to walk around for a bit, because he looks funny. His big doopy glasses. And back to Cecil. Back to Cecil! Now, there's a secret here. In the easy type, in the original translation of this game, the one that Final Fantasy IV easy type, as it's known in Japan, I think, you could actually see these secret passages clear as day on screen. Which is quite nice to have, honestly. Let's see if Tella can remember something. Toad. Good. Well, that worked, I guess. Toad, basically, I think it, sets your attack and defense to 1 or something. It makes you super, super weak. But if you have, magic, that's still, equally as effective, I think. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what the entire ramifications of being toaded are, but they're not good, that's for sure. sun. Why'd you come out outside? You're supposed to be raining. You were raining when I came in. I'm looking out the window. Now, there's not much point to this secret passage. It pretty much just cuts through a bunch of stuff you're gonna have to walk. It's not really any shorter, and there's nothing special on it. It's literally just an alternate path you can take. So I'm not sure why you'd ever use it, but you can use some bolt on some guys. I probably shouldn't have talked through that fight, because, whatever. Already gained a level, that's nice. There, that's my justification for leaving that fight in. I got a potion. Oh, marshmallows. That's odd. I think these guys are weak to fire, which I don't have on Rydia, so I'm going to use the ice rod with her because it's free. And Tella, you can use fire. And kill they ass. Ow. Ouch. Those marshmallows are the, You know, every Final Fantasy game has an enemy like that that's almost invincible to physical attacks, but is weak to a certain kind of magic. Oh, I like this screen. It looks bad on this. Ew. On the original version, here we go, talking about the original translation again, the whole, like, background was the same color, so it looked a lot nicer. There wasn't that bad blue boxing effect around the underground river. Oh, four Gigantoads! Oh, well, this is a surprise. What an interesting battle. I should have used Ice Rod. That would have killed him just as well. Bolt is just going to be over. Oh, maybe not. In fact, it didn't actually kill all of them at all.
Oh, no. Don't cough again. Every single time you cough, your headache hurts.
More. Well, it's eased off by now. I woke up this morning. I was like, oh, no, not again. Because last time I woke up with a headache, I vomited, so that was gross, so that's good. Like you all want to hear that. I mean, jeez. That's disgusting. Just the ice rod and to Toiletel, I can use some bolt magic. I don't know what these blue ones, these Organatodes are weak to, but is that gonna work? No! Urg! Ouch! I should not be recording with this fucking headache. I'm so sick of headaches. Ugh. Frick, how annoying. Hey, you know what? Don't even waste your magic. Just kick your ass with your dark sword. Can we get some fights I don't have to leave in? Holy cow! Rydia with the ice rod. Could. Wow. Oops, I need to be talking. Right. What's in here? Copper hourglass. Wow, that's completely fucking useless. Shadow blade. That is significantly better. That's also not where you found that in the original version, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it was, like, before in that other area where I said there was going to be equipment and then there wasn't. But look at the attack increase on that. 27, where it was 17 before. Now that's what I call recycling. We can go outside from here. The monster lies under the upcoming waterfall. It would be wise to camp in a tent in the overworld just in case. Yeah, okay, to Toiletella. I don't think we really need it, actually. Well, you can never be too careful with this. You can never be too careful, I guess. Ugh. Surprised? Oh, no! Ow. Oh. Ouch. Alright, use Dark Wave and just wreck their faces in. Why am I leaving this fight in? I have no fucking idea. Because I have free will. No, don't get on that. Jeez. I have free will, therefore I can do whatever I want. It's like, well. Let's rest in a tent. You know what? Let's find a better spot to rest. Let's rest right here. That's good. That's a nice camping spot. No, let's save in this spot, too. No, you know what? I'm gonna save right in front of the cave entrance. If I was actually smart, instead of just role-playing, I would have actually used a tent right in front of this cave entrance, too, just in case I got into a random battle all the way walking over to it. But whatever. Underground waterfall. He's down below! Oh, no! We're falling down the waterfall! This is the worst thing to ever happen in this game, except for that one time we plundered an innocent village in the prologue. That was probably worse. Anyway. Why am I recording? My headache is throbbing. Every single time I speak powerfully, people are walking around upstairs with absolute total disregard. And there's an alligator. What a normal name for a monster. That should kill it. Yeah, 130. Oh, it didn't kill it. Holy cow, those guys are buff and they're tough and they can chunk like the best of them, apparently. Haha, what a loser. Now, Rydia, you finish off that alligator with your ice rod, or you can miss. That's okay, too. Ouch. Alright, come on. Kill the alligator. Jeez, man. What is this, Earthbound with tough alligators? Or hard crocodiles, I think they're actually called? Hades Gauntlet. Ugh. How pretentious can you possibly... Oh, that's not the right part. It's this one. Hades. In the original game, these were all just shadow. Hades helmet. I guess it's cooler. But, I don't know. Oh my gosh, you quit walking around like you've got some place to be when you're just lazing around the house. Says the guy sitting in the basement, lazing around the house, playing video games. Don't you just love my hypocrisy? Holy crap, man. I have not gotten a single fight in this whole episode. Actually, no, that's not true. There was one fight I took out. But seriously, okay, use poison and poison all of them. And you can use fire. Fire yum balls. That should poison all of them. I don't think Dark Wave does anything to these guys either. Because it's also Dark Elemental. Fire does respectable damage, but nowhere near good. Well, that did more damage than I was expecting it to, absolutely. Let's use Cure on all these zombies, because Cure in Final Fantasy games, and indeed in most RPGs, I think, actually hurts undead monsters. Which is pretty cool. Now I'm going to use Fire again, and that should finish these guys off. Don't even try fighting these guys one at a time. You'll spend less MP killing them all at once. It's not like you can beat them with physical attacks. Good luck. Hades armor. Hermes shoes. That's an item that uses haste on one character, which is pretty good. I might actually use some of those in this upcoming fight against this boss. Oh, jeez. More new monsters? Mini-Mage, Sahrin. I'm gonna use Remember on Toilatella, see if I can get some crazy powerful magic. Holy cow, that did more damage than I thought it would. Wow. The backtrack. Wow. Did you use Osmose, you asshole? Ouch. Ugh. Oof. These guys are so much worse in the DS version. What? Toilatella, you blew it. Oh man, I hope you can't hear those people, them walking around upstairs. I shouldn't complain. I'm the one who decided to record in the basement. Because I didn't have to. Gee whiz. I think I just heard one of them yelp up there. They're watching like a Harry Potter movie or something. I don't know. Rydia, you ready to use Cure a couple times? Oh jeez, that did not heal a lot at all. There goes, like, half your remaining MP. Anyway, here's the boss. Here it comes! Oh my gosh, it's a super it's an Octomammoth. That's such a cool name for an enemy. I actually thought of building this guy in Minecraft for a while, but that would take forever. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to use a copper hourglass on this boss. I'm pretty sure that inflicts slow. No, it inflicts stop, apparently, because it didn't work. Alright, I'll use Hermes. What? What? Did he? You can't use those? Oh, man, you can't use those on other people? You have to put them on yourself? I mean, I guess that makes sense. But man, that is so annoying, because I was going to use those on Cecil, and he was just going to go buck wild, like, crazy owning this guy. Because this thing, I think, is actually weak to darkness. Either that, or it just has really low defense. Well, probably not that, considering the Chocobo kick only did 92 damage. It is somewhat weak to lightning, but not to the degree that it takes nearly as much damage as when you hit it with Cecil's swords. This guy's crazy weak to darkness, apparently. I'd like to see what this guy's actual like coding is for what does and doesn't work well on him. And of course, as you beat him, he loses tentacles in a nasty-ass way. I think, oddly enough, he also gets slower as you beat him, too, which makes this fight easily get less and less intense as it goes on, in a kind of anticlimactic way. Man, that haste did not do much for Toilatella. MP. I guess you'll use Cure. Just get us some HPs. I'm gonna use Fire, because I don't know, like, maybe it'll do more damage, because he's, like, maybe we can make Calamari or something. Let's try Dark Wave, too. Okay, one damage. That's less. One damage, that's less. Yes. Just what I expected from a Dark Knight. Yeah, its movement is slackening. Thanks for reminding me of how much of an asshole I am. One more attack from Cecil should do it. No? I still got one tentacle left. Hiccup. I have the hiccups now too! What? This might finish him off, or Cecil's attack. I'm not sure. Either or. No? Huh, this guy's last tentacle has more health than I thought than I remember it having. And he resists everything else, so... Well, I guess you can just defend. Because you ain't gonna be doing nothing. Let's not waste any more MP and just go buck wild with Cecil and wreck his face in. This guy's pretty much doomed. There you go. No problem. 500 gil, 400 experience, that's nothing. Cecil gained a level, Ridia gained a level, learned Dejon. What the fuck is that? I think that's like warp. It allows you to leave an area. Now we can proceed to Damsian. Beyond this waterfall is a path to the surface or something. Anyway. So you come out of the cave and... You walk up here and hey, look, it's the castle. Maybe that's Damsian. Wait, what? Is that the Red Wings? Oh my gosh, what are they doing? They're bombing Damsian! Oh no! What are we gonna do? We have to go help them. Next time on Final Fantasy IV, y'all. Ha 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 ha